Good morning, friends. Let's explore some more passages from Siddharameshwar Maharaj. You may find this a bit abstract, but please listen intently, because it echoes the same concepts of non-doership, consciousness and the self in different words. And also, when the word knowledge is used, it is with a capital K, which implies not the knowledge of the thinking mind, but the higher knowledge, the wisdom. So here is the first passage. When one has acquired knowledge, then the sins and virtues accumulated by endless rounds of births are destroyed. In a court before the judge, when it became known that all the evidence being used was from a dream, then the accused was released. Likewise, after realization, Chitragupta and Yama have stated that the one who committed the sins was only an illusion, and he and this knower have no connection whatsoever. Therefore, awakening from the illusory dream, the knower is freed from the bondage of karma and naturally becomes the God of gods. The knower is not affected by karma. Once self-knowledge, the fruit of all fruits, is obtained, one is whole and complete. There is no need for involvement in karma. After becoming a barrister, if once again one sits in school with a slate and pencil, then he is a fool. Likewise, after acquiring knowledge, who will you worship with these articles of puja? Why will the real God go on a pilgrimage to a stone idol? He is complete perfection. I am the body and I am Brahman. Both of these egos have gone. You see, Ramesh ji used to say precisely this, that if nobody is the doer, how can one commit a sin? If all your actions are based on factors you had no control over, there is no question of sin. And that is why so many Western seekers, students who were carrying this load of guilt and sin would come to Ramesh ji, and I myself saw how they would break down sobbing with relief when they heard him say, you cannot commit a sin. So this is what this glorious understanding delivers: freedom from sin and guilt, and karma becomes pure action, not action based on doership. And that is why Rameshji would say karma, according to him, means action, not my action. So the whole concept of karma was healed back to its originality as pure action. Siddharameshwar ji uses such beautiful similes to make us understand, like the barrister, or even like the judge, as he said earlier. When it became known that all the evidence being used was from a dream, Of course, he is referring to this dream of life. The divine hypnosis that makes me think I am the doer, as Rameshji would say. Let's take one more. One must give up the gross, subtle, causal and supracausal bodies and fully understand these four bodies are not me. This conviction is what is meant by leaving all attachment. Otherwise, even by dying, this body conviction is not destroyed. As long as the body conviction remains fixed, then one feels, I am the gross body and I am the subtle body, which is mind, conviction, buddhi, the reasoning faculty and the ego. I am the ignorance of the causal body and the aham brahmasmi. I am Brahman of the supracausal body. Even that subtle ego of I am must be left. As long as these convictions are kept, this gross body keeps standing on the gallows with the noose around its neck. One day it gets destroyed, and then again and again one will take up hundreds of new flesh bodies, and the former tiresome tale begins all over again and gets repeated again and again, and it always leads to death. You see, here Siddharameshwar ji is pointing to the koshas, the sheaths. What we see is only the physical sheath, the gross body, the annamaya kosha. Like this are the subtle sheaths, the pranamaya kosha, the manomaya kosha, the vijnanamaya kosha, and the anandamaya kosha. The sheaths of the prana, of the mind, of the intellect, and of bliss. So, it is not only the gross body that drops. At the time of death, it may appear that that is the end of the story. It is not that. Because the other sheaths, the mind bodies, are still there, the vasanas and the samskaras. And therefore, the perpetuation can continue, the perpetuation of the maya, of the illusion can continue even beyond the dropping of the physical body. So Siddharameshwar ji is pointing to this, that this matter has to be resolved once and for all, else one will keep taking rebirth after rebirth after rebirth. One could say, in a sense, that this bundle of vasanas and sanskaras, etc., will keep reincarnating and reincarnating and reincarnating till the issues are resolved. Perhaps we will explore this topic in detail another time, but what he is pointing out to is that all these matters, all these aspects need to be resolved once and for all. Friends, I hope you enjoyed this. It is indeed a different language from Rameshji, but Siddharameshwar ji raises some very crucial points, and even if one cannot understand it at the level of the mind, they are like seeds planted in the consciousness, as Maharaj would say, that the seeds are planted in the consciousness and will sprout whenever they are destined to. That much is assured. Thank you.